Today's a hot one. Hello, YouTube. This is Nova here. Welcome to my garage. On this episode or video, I actually have my neighbor's car in. It's a late 2007, early 2008 Scion Tc. It's a very nice car. Low mileage. I checked it in at work. We do the inspection on it. I did recommend rear brakes, which were pretty low. The rotors were rusty, especially on the right side. But I'll be showing how to take the rotor apart. I'll just do one side. It's identical to the other side. I don't want to make it too long a video for that. Just the one side, how to take everything apart, put it back together. Hopefully you enjoy this video. It's very hot here today. It's finally summer, but it's very rainy today, which I don't mind. At least it's cooling down just a little bit. But hopefully you enjoy. Thank you so much for watching. With the vehicle lifted just a little bit, just to get some tension off the suspension and tires. This vehicle has aftermarket rims. My neighbor actually finally gave me the key to get these wheel locks off. This is actually a spline. Usually sometimes there's only one lock and then the rest are just normal lug nuts. But this one, all of them have the special key. Usually I use a breaker bar just to get them off. Sometimes use an impact. These keys break and then you're kind of screwed trying to get the rest of them off. Either you have to go to the factory to get a universal key to match it, or you have to use either hammer stock it on or use a lug nut extractor to get the rest of the locks off. I'll just break them free, then jack the vehicle up, put it under your jack stands, and then take the tire back off. When taking the wheel off, this vehicle has aftermarket wheels. The hub ring or eccentric ring fell off. Usually it's a plastic or metal ring that fits on the hub. Make sure if it sticks to the hub, take it off and don't forget to put it back on. Set it off to the side. On the caliper itself, there's one bolt on the bottom that when you remove it, the caliper flips up, slides off, and out of the way. It's a 17 millimeter. Either way. It's actually a slide. The bolt is the slide pin. Sometimes the slide pin, there's an extra bolt that holds the caliper on, and then you just take the bolt out, take the caliper off, and then you can take the slide out. Usually I clean these up, re-grease them before putting them back in. Caliper slides up, slides off the second slider, and out of the way. Make sure you prop it up so it doesn't put stress on the brake hose. Pop the pads out. These are actually getting pretty thin. That's why I recommended them to my neighbor. These are the new ones. See how you can see how thick they are compared to the old one. And then you can machine these rotors. This one's pretty pitted from sitting for a while. Depending on how thick they are, you can actually machine them. I usually recommend just replacing them. Usually if they get them too thin, they start to warp, which you get pulsations in the brake. To save money, but I don't, usually on my vehicles, I just replace everything at one time. On the bracket itself, it's a two 14 millimeter bolts. Bracket comes off. This is the other slider. It is has an Allen key on it, so you can actually take it off if you have to replace this boot. The other one has a boot on the caliper itself that you can get a hardware kit for. I usually clean these sliders up with some emery cloth, or take it to the wire wheel, put some grease on it, put it back together. I'll pop these clips out, these hardware clips. There's one here. One here, and then two on the other side. Here, and here. The kit, the brakes usually come with them. Usually take a screwdriver, pop them out. If I can. Usually they're rusted in there. Come out. Usually I try saving them. If it doesn't come with clips, just clean them up, put them back together. And then underneath the clips, usually rust builds up. And if I can get, there we go. Rust builds up in between. So I'll take a wire brush to clean them up, same thing on this side, and then put the hardware back on, put some grease on it, put it back together, and then the rotor itself, which surprisingly it came out easily, it's pretty bad, some scoring, rust. Most of the time if there's a parking brake that's not with the caliper itself, over time it does get pretty hard to get the rotors off. Usually a lip starts to form right at the very edge. If you use your e-brake a lot, it'll start wearing in, and then when it gets to the very edge, it's hard to actually pull the rotor off. It hits on the lining of the brake shoe. Sometimes the emergency brake will come apart trying to get the rotors off. Usually I use an air hammer to vibrate it loose, or I can access the adjustment screw, usually it's on the bottom or very top from the back side. I'll bring the shoes in as far as I can, and then usually I'll hit the sides or in the middle and then pull, and they'll vibrate loose, it'll come off. I'll clean the hub itself. You don't want any debris, rust. Usually if you don't clean them up and put them on, rust can build up behind it. It'll cause the rotor to stick out just a little bit on that one spot, and it'll either cause a pulsation in the rotors or in the brakes, or when you put the wheels on, if that rust starts breaking apart, the wheels can come loose too. Just safety. And then put everything back together.
Weaver brakes from Advance Auto. They're pretty good. I like the painted ones. They have like a salt spray paint on the hub itself. And then usually if it doesn't have the if it has an integrated parking brake, usually the inside's painted too. It keeps it from rusting from the hub of the wheel going against it. Usually some Castle brake clean, get all the oil off. Some of that. Usually they store them in oil so they don't rust. Usually a parts cleaner will work. Some brake clean, I like brake bath. Works a lot better. Nice and clean.
With the hub cleaned, I have the rotor all nice and clean. Goes back together. Usually I'll put a washer and a lug nut to hold the rotor back together so it doesn't flip-flop around. Make sure it's all tight. Sometimes the old rotor, there's a plug that goes in here, like it's a rubber plug that you can see the lining of the brake shoes on the inside, the parking brake, or you can use it to adjust the parking brake to get it down or to collapse it to get the rotor off. It didn't have one. I don't have any spares with me. I'll tell them to actually go to the parts store and get one later on so no debris or water gets inside to freeze up the parking brake or cause noise when you drive. I got slide pin cleaned up, greased. I have two shims hardware kit put on with grease on them. I cleaned up the underneath them. They just snap right on. You take it, put it on. Usually, sometimes hard to put on, but usually snap on. Make sure they're going the correct way, or they'll start making noise, or the pads won't go on. Usually they're on. Take some grease. Usually throw a lot on, but a little bit will do. Just so that it doesn't make any noise or freeze up. And put it back together. Tight. Usually try to get the correct torque spec for the brackets and the rotor, or not the rotor, the caliper. Usually I can feel it by hand after doing it forever. Make sure the pads curl correct way. Sometimes they're inside outside pads. Some have a little tang on it for the wear mark that they start hitting once they start getting to a certain point. These ones are don't have them, and they're universal, so any side goes, put them on. Just slide right in. And then on the caliper, usually when you compress the piston, I'll take the cap off the reservoir so the fluid can go back in easily, or you can unloosen the bleeder screw, if you can see it. I'll put a hose down to a container, and when I compress it, most of the dirt goes to the lowest spot of the brake system, so most dirt, debris, old brake fluid actually goes into the calipers. Opening it up, compressing it will flush out all the debris. Sometimes I don't like touching them at all because they start freezing, they break, then you have to buy a whole new caliper. If it's on an old vehicle, I'll just compress it. This one's not too old. He had some service work done to it a while back. Usually my tool won't fit in here, my brake compressor. So I'll just use channel locks. Be careful pressing it easily or evenly. And that's it. Make sure there's no fluid coming out of the boot. That'll indicate that the piston ring or piston seal is leaking. And then it just slides right over. Back on. The other slide pin, I'll lube it up. Usually with a lot of grease. Slide it in. The other side. Tight, put the hub ring back on, take off your lug nut, and that's it. With the wheel on, there's some tricks that I keep forgetting to do, but it will kind of save you time. I hate when I put brakes together. There's like three customers in line. Put everything together, test drive it, and I hear squeak, 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 or like a squeaking, or either the backing plate got bent and it's hitting the rotor, or sometimes these shims don't like to fit correctly. They slide out just a little bit more than normal, and the rotor hits them. Or when you hit the brake, they slide with the pad, start hitting the rotor. So I try to spin the wheel. Some normal noise from the pads hitting the rotor, but just to spin it after pumping up the brakes, I don't hear any noises. I didn't move them back and plate that much, but I hate going down, squeak, squeak, and then I have to bring the car back in to take everything apart to either bend the shim back, bend the backing plate back, or even messing around with the parking brake because the parking brake shifted, moved, or hitting it out, bent the back plate and the shoes for the parking brake out more than normal, and it makes a lot of noise. With the jack underneath, it's a late 07, early 2008 Scion Tc, usually 100 foot-pounds. I go in a star pattern, circle afterwards, and then come back within 20 to 50 miles to have it checked again. I usually buy a Harbor Freight Torx stick. I have a Mac one at my work. I keep forgetting to grab, but I do have a torque wrench gauge to actually verify the torque at my work. Usually I'll take these there to verify it. These are actually they're kind of accurate, close to being to what they're putting torque out. usually with these keys, I'll throw them back in the vehicle in the cup holder or where I found them. Most of the time, luckily he had one of these. Most of the time they are either lost when vehicles are sold, traded, or usually they break, or the parts place or shop usually never puts them back in. Usually I put them in the, usually I look for them in the glove box, center console, but mostly they're in the trunk. Either, I think, mostly Kias, Hyundais, some Fords. You can get a factory key with lug nuts. They come in a little box that you open up. Half time they're in the trunk, and then I'll put them back in. I'll tell the customer where it's located at, so they don't have to find out and worry. Or I would hand them the key back in person, so they can get it without it being lost or missing. But I'll put it back in the vehicle, tell them where it's at, so we can actually get the lug nuts retightened or taken back off if need to. I think that's it. Thank you for watching. Any comments or anything I can ask or answer any questions, I can try. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.